The following computer simulation of a high-speed flight around the Los Angeles vicinity was produced to demonstrate a capability of scientific data visualization. This animation is part of the NASA-funded research being carried out at the Jet Propulsion Laboratory. The entire animation was produced from one Landsat satellite image that was merged with digital elevation information. Landsat views the Earth from 570 miles up and is capable of seeing features that are approximately 30 meters square. A 30 meter square area is approximately the same size as the area inside the bases of a professional baseball field. This is Los Angeles, California on July 3rd, 1985. We are now traveling toward the Pacific Ocean at about 200,000 miles an hour and will drop down behind Santa Catalina Island about 26 miles off the coast of Los Angeles. We're going to fly through the isthmus of the island and then cross the coast north of the Santa Monica Mountains. As we head south, we can see features such as Marina del Rey and Los Angeles International Airport. We see the Palos Verdes Peninsula in the center now, along with the Long Beach Harbor. Now, we're moving down into the Orange County area. The bow tie-shaped feature now visible are Balboa and Lido Islands in Newport Bay. We're heading toward Los Angeles, and in the center of the screen is downtown. Hollywood and Beverly Hills are below as we move into the San Fernando Valley. You'll see a V-shaped lake appear. That's Castaic Lake. We will now turn and proceed to fly straight down the rift valley of the San Andreas Fault. We're crossing the East Fork of the San Gabriel Mountains and we'll turn around and face those same mountains when we lose elevation into the Pomona Valley area. We can see Mount Baldy at the top right of the screen, and as we pan the San Gabriel Mountains, we can note in the foreground the Santa Fe Dam and Recreation Area, the Santa Anita Racetrack and Golf Course. You can now see the Rose Bowl with the surrounding golf course. It took 5.5 days of non-stop computer time on a machine capable of computing 4 million instructions per second. Over 3,000 digital frames were generated to make LA the movie. That represents more than 2.6 billion bytes of data. That is equivalent to enough characters to fill 1.3 million pages of text. That would be a stack of paper over 44 stories tall. Techniques developed during the creation of LA the movie will be used to help scientists analyze the large quantities of data being sent back to Earth by satellites.
A study of the Earth's climate must take into account the crucial role played by clouds. Besides delivering life-giving rain to the land, clouds help maintain a proper balance in the global climate. The following digital animation combines satellite cloud data and Earth elevation data from maps to demonstrate how atmospheric scientists and visualization specialists team up to perform climatic research. The clouds were derived from infrared and microwave satellite instrument data using a supercomputer. At first glance, clouds may appear chaotic, but closer observation reveals a semblance of order. Recognizable patterns show how air moves up and down while circulating around the globe. The varied features of the Earth's surface, portrayed here by color, as well as prevailing winds, have distinct effects on the formation and distribution of clouds. Computer animation to visualize clouds provides a unique insight into the structure and dynamics of global weather systems. Now, as we add the third dimension to both the Earth's surface and the clouds, we can see the relationship between cloud tops and the Earth's topography. The cloud top elevations were also derived from satellite data. The vertical dimensions have been exaggerated 20 times to enhance comparison. Our flight first takes us along the west coast of Africa. Flying north of Scandinavia, we see Europe. Then quickly cross the North Atlantic and drop below the cloud tops off the eastern United States. We look west into the Amazon basin of South America. We circle Cape Horn and view the Andes Mountains up close. Central America passes below as we view North America. Diving below the clouds in the mid-Atlantic, we fly over the Mediterranean. Turkey passes to our right as we fly across the Caspian Sea into the southern Soviet Union. China and now Japan are below us. Southeast Asia and Australia are seen as we head for the Himalayas and Indian subcontinent. The Middle East and Africa complete our journey. The atmosphere can be considered a gigantic solar-powered engine which controls our daily weather. The Pacific Ocean, shown here, covers nearly half the Earth. It is the major storehouse of energy and source of water vapor for the planet. This is the winter season in the Northern Hemisphere, and we can observe the course of numerous storms, one after the other, approaching North America from the Gulf of Alaska. Note the belt of clouds near the equator as we rotate the Earth to observe the opposite hemisphere. This belt provides the moisture necessary to sustain the equatorial rainforests of the Congo Basin in Central Africa and the Amazon in South America. North Africa, dominated by the Sahara, is characterized by its lack of clouds. Near the top of this hemisphere, we can also observe winter storms move with regularity across the North Atlantic and Europe. The data visualization techniques developed to produce Earth the Movie represent powerful new tools that scientists will use to study our complex global environment.
Thank you. Mars, the fourth planet from the sun, is visible to the naked eye as a bright star in the night sky. Through a telescope, it appears as a yellowish-brown disk with indications of complex features. However, using images taken by cameras on the Viking orbiter spacecraft, a simulated flight over Mars reveals much more detail. These are shaded relief maps of the topography of the Earth and Mars rendered onto spheres. The diameter of Mars is 4,202 miles, or about 53% of Earth's. The planet's volume is about 15% of Earth's. A comparison of the relative size of each planet to the size of its surface features demonstrates the enormity of the Martian terrain. The Mars elevations were derived from stereographic analysis of the Viking orbiter imagery. For scale, the outline of the continental United States is superimposed on a portion of the Martian terrain over which our flight will occur. Among the most impressive features on Mars are the Tharsis Mantis, shield volcanoes more than two times the height of Mount Everest, and the Valles Marineris, a system of enormous canyons over 3,000 miles long. This Viking orbiter image mosaic was used for the flight simulation. The line being drawn follows the flight path. Flight elevations vary from 500 miles to 3 miles above the surface. The relief has been exaggerated 5 times and the natural color enhanced to allow better interpretation of small surface features. For centuries, Mars has captivated observers on Earth. Unmanned spacecraft and scientific data visualization have increased our interest in and knowledge of the Red Planet.
Venus, the brightest star in the evening sky, has captured our imaginations for centuries. Its thick, swirling clouds have never allowed a camera or telescope to glimpse the surface below. Since August of 1990, though, a spacecraft named Magellan has peered beneath this veil of mystery to show us the surface of Venus in unsurpassed detail. The secret of Magellan's success is a sophisticated radar instrument that operates with incredible speed and efficiency. During a burst of activity that lasts less than 1 second, Magellan acquires imaging, altimetry, and radiometry data. This information is used to make images of the Venusian terrain to determine the heights of surface features and to measure the microwave energy that is naturally emitted from the planet. Magellan gathers data for approximately 25 minutes during each 3-hour orbit around the slowly turning planet. Starting at the North Pole and moving south, Magellan maps in swaths or strips that cover an area about 16 miles wide and nearly 7,000 miles long. Twice during each orbit, Magellan turns its dish antenna toward Earth and transmits the data it has just acquired. While this happens, engineers on Earth track the changing motions of the spacecraft to learn about Venus's gravitational field. The large antennas of NASA's Deep Space Network receive the stream of data from Magellan, then transfer it to NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory. Computers process the data into 15-foot-long image strips. These strips provide the first look at what Magellan has discovered. Additional processing of the strips reveals exciting and sometimes puzzling details. A massive lava flow that appears to come from the rim of an impact crater. A 4,000-mile-long lava channel that is unequaled in the inner solar system. And an unexplained jet-like streak associated with another impact crater.
Magellan has given us a more detailed view of Venus than we've ever had before. Needless to say, all of our scientists and their students are thrilled, not only with the quality of the data, but by the quantity. We've returned more imaging data from Magellan so far than all U.S. planetary missions combined. We've begun to use some new evolving computer technology to combine the images with altimetry data and make simulated flights over the surface of the planet. Let's take one of those excursions now.
Our flight begins at 3 impact craters. The largest crater is approximately 40 miles across, about the size of the Los Angeles basin. The bright rims were created from debris that was thrown out when huge meteorites hit the surface. Moving southeast, we pause to observe a small volcanic caldera, then rise to focus on Alpha Regio, a highland region in the southern hemisphere that spans 800 miles. The circular feature at lower left is a corona. These features are found only on Venus and are thought to be volcanic in nature. Now we descend for a closer look at the complex terrain of Alpha Regio. Our path then zooms east over jagged ridges to a volcano with a fluted rim, unofficially called the Tick. Our journey through Alpha Regio continues over hundreds of miles of rugged territory. Turning northeast, we leave this tortured area and head to 7 pancake-shaped domes. These volcanic eruptions rise up to a half mile above the surface and average 15 miles across. They may be made of thick, sticky lava. Such domes have only been seen on Venus. Our flight then continues to the west and ends near the rim of an impact crater.
I think you'll agree that this is a pretty exciting way to look at the data, but more importantly, it gives us a way to compare the relationships among the surface features. I'd like to mention at this point that the color we use is taken from an actual photograph from a Soviet probe that landed on the surface of Venus in 1981. Now let's continue the journey.
Straight ahead is Sif Mons, a volcano that towers more than a mile above the surface of Venus. As we approach its sprawling base and climb to slowly circle the peak, many lava flows and other scars reveal the volcano's violent past. We turn south to look at another crater. Then a quick flight to the east brings us to the mouth of an extraordinary 600-mile-long rift valley. We arrive at another volcano named Gula. Here we skim its mile-high summit and descend to view the lava flows and ridged terrain of its northwestern face. A volcanic caldera now in sight is further evidence of Venus's active geologic history. We now turn east and follow a dark streak of unknown origin that leads to two impact craters and a lava flow that has traveled many miles from its source. Looking northeast, we ascend for a panoramic view of the area just explored, the western portion of Isla Regio, an elevated zone in Venus's northern hemisphere.
The last part of our trip takes us over Artemis, a broad, sweeping canyon that's of great interest for geology and geophysics. This canyon is so beautiful that it would be a tourist attraction if it were on Earth.
Although Magellan completed its first mapping cycle in May of 1991, its exploration of Venus will continue for several years. An important strategy for the extended mission was to change the angle of the spacecraft so Magellan can record a different view of the surface. Will Magellan's multiple observations of Venus reveal changes in the surface features? Is Venus, like Earth, still an active planet? These and many other questions about this intriguing planet are likely to be answered as current and new generations of scientists analyze the legacy of data provided by the Magellan mission. Venus is often called Earth's sister planet because they are similar in size, mass, and distance from the Sun. What Magellan teaches us about Venus will undoubtedly help us to understand the similarities and differences of all of the members of our solar family.
The following animation demonstrates an application of scientific data visualization. Using 9 images taken by the Voyager 2 spacecraft, planetary geologists and visualization specialists created a computer-simulated flight over the southern hemisphere of Miranda, a geologically interesting moon of the planet Uranus. The flight takes us over a bewildering array of landforms. As we simulate flight over the terrain at altitudes of 3 to 20 miles, keep in mind that Voyager 2's closest approach to Miranda was more than 18,000 miles above the surface.